So the first trailer for The Matrix Resurrections just dropped, and I can't wait to see it. Let's do this.
Thomas? You seem particularly triggered right now. Can you tell me what happened?
I've had dreams that weren't just dreams.
Am I crazy? We don't use that word in here.
Hi.
Have we met?
One pill makes you larger, and one pill makes you small. And the ones that mother gives you don't do anything at all. Go ask Alice when she's 10 feet tall.
Time to fly.
If you want the truth, Neo, you're going to have to follow me.
The only thing that matters to you is still here. I know it's why you're still fighting and why you will never give up.
You don't know me.
No?
Years to be going back to where it all started, back to the Matrix.
Alrighty, real quick before I share my thoughts on the trailer, go ahead and join me down below in the comment section. Share your thoughts on the trailer as well as your thoughts on the Matrix trilogy as a whole. On that point, if you want to know my thoughts on the Matrix trilogy, check out my ranking of the movies somewhere right up here when the video is over. Now, I want to watch this trailer one more time, and then I'm going to start talking. Okay, so I'm of the generation that was in high school when the original Matrix came out. So for me, it was one of those formative, R-rated movies that we are all finally able to go see and have our minds absolutely blown by it. And it was a film that was a big hit when it came out, but like it even like grew in popularity over the next several years as we waited for the sequels. And then likewise, I'm part of that generation that went to go see the second one, kind of lied to ourselves a little bit and be like, man, that wasn't so bad. That was all right. And then when we saw the third one, we were like, no, that was bad. Both these sequels, no, these are not good. And so we've been waiting over 20 years for a good Matrix sequel. Now, does this trailer look like a good Matrix sequel? Well, it looks like a respectable Matrix rehashquel based off the trailer thus far, which on the one hand, I don't actually mind that all that much. If based off the trailer, looks like we got Neo back in the Matrix, realizes something is a little bit off about it, and then our Morpheus character pulls him out, trains him, and then he starts beating people up inside the Matrix after getting trained. Sounds a lot like what they did in the original Matrix. Even certain shots in there, sequences seem very reminiscent of things in the original film. And so, what do I feel about that? If it's a very safe follow-up that tries to repeat the beats, one of these homage sequels that's paying tribute to a film that people love from decades past, I'll probably like the film. I probably won't watch it and be like, oh, why are we doing this again? I'll watch it and be like, well, I'm glad to see more of this stuff that I like without a story that drives me crazy and makes me want to pull the hair out of my head. At the same time, part of what makes the original so fresh, so exciting, was its ability to take all these familiar elements, or, I mean, I guess they weren't all that familiar to Hollywood at the time, but taking inspiration from John Woo action movies, Yuen Woo-ping martial arts films, from manga, from anime, from The Terminator, and just mash them all together into something fresh and original. Not unlike the way that Quentin Tarantino takes inspiration very heavily from the movies that he loves and pays homage to his films, but makes it entirely new. That's what the original Matrix did with all these different sci-fi action genres. And this trailer looks like it's a director paying tribute to their own work, which is interesting. It's not the most, pretty far from the most exciting thing you could do with The Matrix. Then again, I don't know what you do to refresh things with how much they burn some bridges. And maybe that's why they're heading in this direction, is that they know people didn't like the fact that in the sequels they totally deconstructed their own film to pieces. And thus they went, okay, we destructed it, destructed our own stuff. Let's reconstruct our own thing and maybe not take it in such a wacky direction that undoes everything that people loved about our original film. I mean, that's what they're doing, and not a terrible idea. So putting some final thoughts on it. Didn't in any way like exceed my expectations for what's coming. Maybe shrunk my window of feelings. The Wachowskis over the last 20 years have not had the best track record. The last movie that the Wachowskis directed, and I know this is only one of them directed, that I dug was the original Matrix over 20 years ago. And they've had some things that weren't so bad or some interesting ideas, but they haven't had a full-blown wow since 1999. So you know they could direct one of the best sci-fi action movies of all time, and then they've done a bunch of other stuff that's not so great at all. This trailer made me go, okay, maybe this is my window. Instead of this, the full-blown spectrum of how good this thing could be, it's not going to get anywhere close to the heights, but it looks safe enough that it's not going to go to the low points either. And oh, hey, the baby. My baby just walked in here. I guess she woke up and decided to come in and see me. So right there is what it kind of, this trailer did for me. Shrunk my window of the spectrum of expectations. I think we're going to get a very safe Matrix rehashquel that will pay good tribute, won't deconstruct the mythology, will have some amazing action sequences, some very cool visuals, but not really blow any minds. That's kind of what I'm expecting at this point in time, and I'm good enough with that. Let me know what you thought down below in the comments section. If you want to know my thoughts on, full thoughts on the Matrix trilogy, check out that video right over there. Thank you so much for watching, and keep talking movies too much.